Wow. What a week. Church family, brothers and sisters, we have never experienced anything like this. So surreal. COVID-19 has cocooned us like caterpillars. Lord willing, we're going to emerge from these cocoons. And when we do emerge, I believe we'll be emerging into a changed world. This global problem is going to change us in ways that we haven't seen and can't see yet. And my hope is that the isolation that we've been experiencing will cause us to long for the gospel community that we've so often taken for granted. Today, I was reading some articles, as we've all been reading, but this article that I read, instead of statistics about COVID-19, this author began to tell the stories of some of the people and their families that COVID has killed, and it really sobered me. It really saddened me. So much bad news. And the bad news of this crisis is testing something that we've preached, that I've preached in moments of peace and tranquility. Jesus plus nothing equals everything. For anyone, Grace, does Jesus plus nothing really equal everything? I believe that truth is as significant and true in times of crisis like we're in right now as it is when in times of tranquility. Church, we can and we will face the bad news with a bold hope. We can face this pandemic with the promises of God. We can face this crisis with confidence. And that's the purpose of the liturgy, the attached liturgy that you've received, and the sermon that I preached from Psalm 91 this week, which was pre-recorded earlier. And I hope that you're helped by it. I hope that the time of singing that some of the members of the worship team created, and the sermon that I've preached, that God will use it to anchor us to truth in these trying times. Let me also just highlight a couple things. You'll see these in the opportunities for community and mission. The first is the care form. You received that last week. You're receiving it again this week. There's a link to the care form. That's what you can use to make us aware of any needs that you have. Some people have already used that. They've made us aware of the needs. The deacons team were rallied and they've been meeting the needs of the church. So church, please be making us aware of the needs that you have. Second is the volunteer form. The volunteer form is what we want you to use because we want to know how the church will be able to serve, particularly needs in the church and needs in the community. As we focus in on the needs of the church, I believe we'll be able to turn our attention, particularly in food distribution, to the community. So we need to know how and when you can serve. So please click on the link for the volunteer form. And then finally, our missional communities, many of them have been meeting, virtual meetings. And I've talked to a number of people who've said it's been really helpful in this time of isolation to actually connect with some people and have some fellowship, to pray together, to read the word together. So if you're not part of a missional community and you'd like to jump in on one, click on the link. It'll take you to a list of our missional communities. Contact the leader and you can get some more information. We'll obviously be in touch in the coming week through more video and more email and communication. But I pray that God would take this liturgy and use it to anchor us to some truth in these trying times. Church, grace and peace until we talk again.